Annyeonghaseyo, annyeonghaseyo. Welcome to Break Time and good evening, everyone. This is your Break Time host, Kuya Oli. Hello. Ready na ba ang mga ballpen nyo at ang mga pen and papers? But of course, before we start, I would just like to remind all of you that we do this every Wednesday night. We study God's Word every 8 p.m. in the evening. So always tune in every Wednesday night, 8 p.m. Winnipeg time. Oh, ready na ba kayo? Yung mga nanonood dyan sa Pilipinas, dito sa Winnipeg, all over the world. Hello! Good evening. And before we start, let us all pray, okay? Heavenly Father, we just want to praise and thank you for this night, Lord God, of again, Lord God, studying your word, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, that the Holy Spirit will lead us tonight, Lord God, as we study your word, Lord God. Let the Holy Spirit speak on my behalf. And I pray, Lord God, that the people who are watching, who are listening, who are in their couches, Lord God, in their bedrooms, with their friends, with their loved ones, who wants to study the word, I pray that we will all, Lord God, understand your word tonight. And I pray, Lord God, that we will be able to apply it in our day-to-day life. And I pray, Lord God, that because of this, we will come to know you more. We will encounter you more. We will know who is God that we serve. And Lord God, we pray that we will have a good life because of this, Lord God. All this we pray in your mighty holy name, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Once again, good evening. This is your Kule Oli, your Break Time host. We have a very interesting topic tonight. Our topic is, why do you need to humble yourself and be thankful to God? Wow! Why do we need to humble ourselves in the eyes of God? Why do we need to be thankful? Because I will be discussing four things why we should humble ourselves and be thankful to our Lord. Mm-hmm. Annyeonghaseyo. Oy, ready na ba? Get your pen and papers ready because we will start. This is my engagement question from the topic itself. Why do you need to be humble and thankful? That's my question. Ako, why do I need to be humble? Kasi, love ako ni Lord. Kasi, di ako pinapabayaan. Interesting. Kayo, why do you need to be humble and be thankful to God? And we will answer that question. So, are you all ready? Woohoo! Number one, the reason why we need to humble ourselves and be thankful to God is number one, because God loves all of us. Again, God loves all of us by sparing His own Son. Let me read you the verse. What shall we say about such wonderful things as this? If God is for us, who can be against us? Since He did not spare even His own Son, but gave Him up for all of us. Listen, guys, listen. God spare His own Son, Jesus Christ, for us. Won't He also give us everything else? Who dares accuse us whom God has chosen for His own? No one, for God Himself has given us the right standing with Himself. Who then will condemn us? No one, for Christ Jesus died for us and was raised to life, and He is sitting in the place of honor at God's right hand, pleading for us. Grabe, grabe to. This is Romans 8, 31 to 32. I mean, Romans 8, 31 to 33. So, let's just recall it. God's love all of us by sparing His own Son. Let us see the explanation here. Letter A, God spare His own Son. Imagine, God, okay, gave His Son Jesus to die for our sin so we can have a right standing with God. Oliver, medyo, we cannot understand it. What does it mean? Okay. If you are not yet a follower of Christ, meaning you are not yet a Christian, you have not been yet born of the Spirit, okay? Let's make it easier. You are not yet a follower of Christ. Now, if you are not yet a follower of Christ, we are all sinners. All of us are still sinners if you have not yet accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Now, what does it mean when God spared His own Son? What does it mean when we say we can have a right standing with God? The right standing deeper meaning is the quality. Listen, guys, what does the right standing deeper meaning? The right standing deeper meaning is the quality of being right in the eyes of God. It's not doing what is right. It is being right in the eyes of God, including our character, our nature. We are before sinners. If you have accepted Jesus Christ, your character is now in right standing with God. Sinners no more. Your conscience are now right in the eyes of God. Your conduct, your action, and your command, the word we speak, it is now being right in the eyes of God because of Jesus Christ. Righteousness. Remember this, guys. Righteousness is based upon God's standard because He is the ultimate law giver. That is the meaning. That is the deeper meaning of having a right standing with God. And that is because of the cross. That is because of the death of Jesus Christ. He became sin for us, so that we can have a right standing with God. I would just like to emphasize on verse 34. In Romans 8, 34, he said, "Who will then condemn us? No one. For Christ Jesus died for us and was raised to life for us. And He is sitting in the place of honor of God's right hand, pleading for us." So when you accept Jesus Christ, remember the way it is explained, God, Jesus Christ is just beside God, pleading for us, for us to have a right standing with God. That's why it was said, Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through Jesus Christ. Wow, it's so powerful. That's the first one. God spared His own Son. That's why we need to be humble and be thankful. Because we will go to heaven whether we like it or not if we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. And that is eternal life. This place is just a temporal place for us. You have to understand that. And I pray that you will really understand this Bible study today, tonight. I'm sorry. Number two. So now, there is no more condemnation for those who belong to Christ Jesus. And because you belong to Him, the power of life-giving Spirit has freed you from the power of the sin that leads to death. Wow! That's Romans 8:1. Meaning, if you fall short after you've accepted Jesus Christ, if you fall short again, if you commit a mistake, if you lie, if you did something wrong, remember, in the eyes of God, sin are all the same. So when you commit a sin, you are not condemned anymore. Because Jesus Christ already paid for it. There's no more condemnation for us who are with Jesus Christ. We are now protected. All of our body from head to foot, we are now protected by the blood of Christ. It doesn't mean that you have to continuously sinning. Because once you accept Jesus Christ, you now have the Holy Spirit who lives in you. The Holy Spirit is the Spirit, is the one that guides us on our day-to-day life. He is the one that convicts us, that tells us the wisdom of God, that help us to do good works. Because of Christ, we will now bear fruit through good works. So it will not save you if you just do good works. But once you accept Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit will now come to your life. God will now be in your heart. The Holy Spirit is the one that will guide you on your day-to-day life. He is the one who will convict you. He is the one who will teach you what to do. He will give you the wisdom of our Lord Jesus Christ. Grabe, no? Again, God spared His own Son. Number two, there's no more condemnation. So if you are being condemned, somebody's whispering to you na you're still a sinner. No. Jesus already clothed your whole body with His blood. You have now a right standing with God. Wow! Woohoo! That's why you have to humble yourself and be thankful to God. Because when you die, I can assure you, you will go to heaven. And letter C, number three, because you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, we now became God's adopted son. We are God's heir of God's glory. We must, but guys, here's the thing. If we are God's adopted son, we will also share in his sufferings. Let me just read Romans 8:15 to 17. So you have not received a spirit that makes you fearful slaves. Instead, you receive God's spirit when he adopted you as his own children. Now we call him Abba, Father. For his spirit joins with our spirit that we are God's children. And since we are his children, we are his heirs. In fact, together with Christ, we are heirs of God's glory. But if we are to share his glory, we must also share his sufferings. Meaning, even if you're now a follower of Christ, you're a Christian, you're reborn of the Spirit, you will still have suffering in this place, in this, on this earth. But Jesus, the Holy Spirit, and God our Father will be our strength, will be our strength whenever we are faced with challenges. Because we have a Father whom we can pray and we have hope and who love us. Imagine he even spared his own son just for us to have a right standing with God, to be a children of God. Wow. And this is the last one. Why do you need to humble yourself and be thankful to God? Because nothing can separate us from the love of Christ. Let me just read this passage to you in Romans 8. And I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love. Kaya kapatid, brothers and sisters, if you haven't experienced God's love yet, if you are having problems now, if you are not happy with your life, if you have troubles, remember this. Nothing can separate us from the love of Christ. Again, let me read it. And I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love. Neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today, nor our worries about tomorrow, not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or in the earth below, indeed, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. So those are the four things. Why do you need to humble and be thankful to God? Let's have a summary. Number one, God loves us all by sparing his own son, Jesus Christ. Number two, there's no more condemnation for those who belong to Christ Jesus. And because of that, we become adopted of God's son. We will share his glory. And that's why nothing can separate us from the love of Christ. So I hope and pray that this strong message hit your hearts. And I pray that you will have a personal relationship with the Lord. So if you are that person today who want to have a personal relationship with the Lord, please pray this prayer with me. Dear Jesus, I confess my sins and receive you into my life as your Lord and Savior. Thank you for your love, mercy, and grace. Today, I'm turning over part of my life to your management. Thank you for your unconditional love. I want to use the rest of my life to love and serve you instead of serving myself. I commit my life to you, Lord Jesus, to save me and accept me in your family. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen and amen. So if you pray that prayer, welcome to God's family. And remember these four things. And I pray that this will make you humble and be always thankful to God. And now we move on to our closing questions. Oh, pen and paper. What did you learn today? Wow. How will you apply it on your day-to-day life? And lastly, what will you do when you commit a mistake? Remember, it should be unintentional, okay? Again, God bless all of you. Anya sayo. This is your Kuya Oli, your break time host. See you again next week, Wednesday night, 8 p.m. God bless and be good to everybody. Smile and always have a love of heart. Mwah, mwah. Good night.